So, I'm running elementary on a quick emulator, and because I do some more things than recording demos for YouTube, like applying pull requests and such, I want to shortly describe the terrible experience I get. For example, back and forward mouse buttons don't work, copy and paste to clipboard doesn't work, elementary desktop itself runs extremely slow, and even some Gala components like push gestures and grubs are ignored. I know that elementary is mostly the desktop project rather everything else, but they really need to move to up-to-date Ubuntu releases. There is virtually not comparison in OS quality between Ubuntu 20.04 and elementary 5, that is based on 18.04. Running 2 years behind in software, it is a damn huge gap, and it is immediate obvious to every user, no matter what they do in their PC. And I want to talk a bit more about the LTS. Even in workstation simulations we have in work, we don't really have the concept of LTS, certainly we don't update kernels that often, but that's mostly because of some hardware kernel modules we don't upstream. That aside, there is almost nothing more LTS on these machines. LTS in general applies on certain components, you can't just LTS the full stack and work with old software like elementary does. And anyway, I don't want to talk for Linux at work, that the only elementary you will ever see it would be at the Linux experiment channel, that even there, elementary only runs on Nick's personal laptop. I only care about Linux at home, and elementary totally sacrifices the most important aspect. That is the community support, that is always upstream and up to date. So elementary maybe is advertised as a Linux for newcomers, but in reality it is a system for veterans that know how to update and maintain various components. And unless elementary starts to rolling releases more often, it will never become a more mainstream Linux. Not in work, not in home, and definitely not to my PC. And the point of saying all those? Never mind. Let's open settings instead. The first thing is that we have a tweaks panel inside official settings app, and that's possible because elementary settings supports plugins. And now you have the baby woe permission to cry on comments about GNOME tweaks and shell extensions. So, we have some appearance options, and what I definitely want to do here is to switch to dark theme. But we have to close and reopen the app for changes to take effect. No idea why, but anyway. Another option you may want to change here is the window control buttons layout. For example, we can set all controls to the left side. But I'm going to keep elementary default, without really preferring it though. On fonts I will obviously going to switch to the lovely Google Sans. This font works like magic. You can't even imagine how many people are asking me about it. Oh, and I will also increase to size 10. What a stupid way for elementary to create smaller interfaces. On animation options we can change the timings, but I will keep everything as it is. On miscellaneous we can change the max volume, and that perhaps should have been on official settings. And in the Lord's name, the single click policy should also have been an official option on file settings. And I will also turn off tabs restore. On launcher there is nothing exciting to do, so I will do nothing. On terminal we have some more interesting options, but again I will do nothing. And last is the video player settings, but MPV for the win, so screw that. So that's our dark files app, and we have the single click policy up and running. But one thing I do not like with the dark switch is that it changes the wing panel and every desktop component too. I prefer if those were still using the light variant.